Jay-Z being the Illuminati, a smart pope being in leagues with the devil, and is even Batman working with the devil? All of this on today's most amazing top 10 list. Coming in at number 10, we have Jay-Z. Can you become the king of the rap game without selling your soul to the devil? Well, probably, but people still think that Jay-Z must have made some sort of deal with the devil in order to make it to the top. There's a lot of hints of satanic symbols in his music videos, and people think that he is in the Illuminati. And this could be real. Maybe him and Beyonce are in a league of evil rich people who want to make the world fall apart so they can control it. But in order to think that Jay-Z is in the Illuminati and sold his soul to the devil, you have to believe in the Illuminati, and you have to believe in the devil. And if you don't believe in either of those, Jay-Z is just a very successful guy. That's it. Coming in at number 9, we have Johann Georg Faust. Now this one's a little bit of a weird one, because it's hard to tell if a dude from the 16th century sold his soul to the devil, because he actually put a pentagram on the ground, threw some goat's blood on it, and did a little dance and sung a little song, and then shook hands with the devil, or was it because he was just an astronomer, and back then people thought that meant you worked with the devil. But this dude apparently worked with the devil to get his fame. The devil offered him 16 years at the top of the world of science. When his time came, the devil arrived and he renegotiated. He was able to squeeze out another 8 years out of the devil, and at the end of the 8 years, he would pass and everyone would say the devil took his soul. Now this is the part of the story that makes it seem like there could have been something to do with the devil going on. When he died, apparently there was an explosion of fire, and all that was found was bits and pieces of his body. Now this could have been an experiment gone wrong that took place in Faust's home, but I don't know what kind of explosives an astronomer would be messing around with. People think that this explosion could have been the devil popping in and ripping his soul right from his body. Maybe he shouldn't have made this deal. Who knows? Coming in number 8, we have Tom Hanks. No way. Not Tom Hanks. There's no way that one of the nicest dudes in the world could have sold his soul to the devil. Well, let's look at the evidence first. He has not only been very successful in Hollywood, but he has also won many Oscars. That is supposed to be a sign that you are part of the Illuminati. He has a really rude son, and that might be because God has cursed him for worshiping the devil. I mean, that is probably just what happens when a kid grows up rich and his parents are too nice to put him in his place, but it also could be the work of God laying down his wrath. But even all of that doesn't mean he sold his soul to the devil so he could be rich through the Illuminati forever. But then people who love to dive deep into conspiracy theories say that Tom Hanks got coronavirus. So that means that he is a pawn in the Illuminati plan. He faked getting sick so that people would believe in the virus and they could continue to take over the world. Whoa! I love these sold your soul stories because they just get crazier and crazier. Coming at number 7, we have Urbain Grandier. It would seem that the devil's reach is far because he has even made a pact with a dude who was the Pope. Now, there isn't a whole lot of evidence that proves whether or not Urbain sold his soul before or after he was Pope, but there is a lot of evidence that this dude was up to some nefarious stuff. He would apparently host and had a number of sexual partners. There's stories of him torturing people who he didn't agree with, and he was also practicing witchcraft. There was a group of nuns that was said to have disrespected him, the Pope of all people, and he sent a demon after them to ruin their life. Well, unlike now, back when this dude was Pope in 1634, if people thought you were up to something with the devil, you would be done for sure. Enough people came forward and accused this guy of witchcraft that there was a trial. During the trial, there was a lot of evidence. There was a contract that had backwards writing on it, said to be the work of the devil, that had the devil's signature on it, or apparently it did. I'm not sure how they fact-checked that one. But many people came forward to disclose this guy's un-pope-like acts, and eventually he was burned at the stake. My God. Coming in at number 6, we have Pope Sylvester II. Two popes back to back. I think it's just salacious to say that a pope was in cahoots with the devil. That's why when you go through history, you can find a few popes that have been called out for loving the Dark Lord. Now, the difference with Pope Sylvester is that it wasn't that he was excessively rich or because he was involved in sinful acts, it was actually because he was too smart. This guy invented the pendulum lock and the hydraulic organ, and he was in contact with Eastern religions and peoples to get ideas of what they were doing over there so he could incorporate their brilliance into his own society. And because of this, people said he might have got his all-powerful mind from making a deal with the devil. I guess things never change, because now when someone makes it to the top, everyone says they're in the Illuminati. Coming in at number 5, we have Eminem. We all love the story of someone starting at the bottom and now they're here. We love when people are the underdog and work their way to the top. We love how people can defy the odds and become one of the most influential people in the world. Well, that's until they're actually at the top. Then we want to bring them down because it must have been the devil that got them all the way up there. That's the story with Eminem. There have been countless accusations that the rapper made a deal with the devil to jump to stardom and forever be held as one of the best rappers of all time. This is from some of the imagery that you will find in his music videos, whether it's a goat's head, a triangle, a single eye, or many of the other objects that are related to the devil. Well, the rumors about him don't stop there. They also say that the real Eminem is dead, that when he fell out of the public eye for a bit, he pushed back against the Illuminati and no longer wanted to do their bidding. So they killed him and replaced him with a clone that they can control. And that's where he got his perfect beard from. Coming in at number 4, we have Jaden Smith. Can you pass down a deal with the devil to your kids? Like kind of grandfathering them into the product like an old phone contract? Is that possible? Can you do that? I don't know how the devil works. I'm not famous enough to get in contact with him. But apparently Jaden Smith has been gifted the allegiance to the devil through his dad. People base this off of Will Smith's fame and the fact that Jaden has some strange beliefs about the world. He's very interested in a thing called orgos. It's a strange culty belief that the world is governed by positive and negative forces that we can't see. That kind of sounds like midichlorians from Star Wars. But people think that he's using a demonic subsect to try and get people into the Church of Satan. Coming in at number 3, we have Katy Perry. If you become a massive celebrity, there's only one answer, and that is the Illuminati. There's no other reason you could make it to the top. Well, for Katy Perry, that's what everyone thinks. There is a ton of stuff we could pull from, but her biggest one is the music video Dark Horse. Because if any celebrity does anything that even comes close to resembling a pyramid, you better believe that conspiracy theory people are going to come running for it. And of course, this music video has an Egyptian theme, meaning that she must have sold her soul to the devil. There was also the time she performed at the Grammys and they had her in a witch's theme with a massive crystal ball. This means that she was, of course, doing a satanic ritual in front of the whole world. I mean, what else could it be? Coming in at number 2, we have Oliver Cromwell. Cromwell was a fading politician and commander in the 17th century. Every champion must fall, and usually they don't get back up after their time has come. But with Cromwell, it was quite the opposite. He was able to have a second breath in his career. He was able to stand in the limelight once more. He was able to have all the people clamor at his feet and become the top dog once again. This second run at life saw him become a prominent political figure and a very skilled tactician. While this was probably hard work and intelligent moves, most people wrote this off as the man selling his soul to the devil. Now, the backing to this theory comes from the legend about him when he dies. There was apparently a storm that came over the city and was raging the entire night. People say this was the devil coming down to claim his soul. Now, that might have been true, but I don't know if the devil would go to that much work to get one soul. This guy's getting thousands of souls every day, hundreds of thousands every day. If he had to put on a massive light show to get each one of them, he would never be able to wrangle them all up. He just wouldn't have enough time. And coming into the number 1 spot, we have Christian Bale, probably the best Batman ever, and one of the kings of the meme world with the amount of juice people have been able to pull out of his hit American Psycho. I've never seen American Psycho, but I want to just so I can have a better understanding of what scenes these memes come from. But when did the Dark Knight himself decide to give his soul to the devil and become one of the Dark Lord's little minions? Well, we don't know the exact time of when this might have happened, but Christian Bale has actually publicly thanked Satan. After winning a Golden Globe for his work in the movie Vice, where he played Dick Cheney, remember the vice president who shot his friend by mistake, and might have had a hand in the whole Guantanamo Bay thing? Well, during his acceptance speech, Christian Bale went down the regular road of saying thank you to all the people close to him, and then he capped it off by saying thank you to Satan for inspiration. Now, this might have just been the actor taking a stab at how ruthless Dick Cheney is, saying that the man is actually the devil, or maybe he was actually thanking the devil for giving him the juice he needs to do what he needed to do to play the role. Like the devil materialized in his room and helped him go over lines. If that is the case, the devil doesn't seem like that bad of a dude. Anyways guys, I've been your host Jay Dorena, thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Coming in at number 9, we have Johann George because it's hard to tell if a dude from the 16th century sold his soul to the... That's why when you go through history, you can find a foo... That's... Now the difference between... Now the difference with Pope Sylvester is that... Well, now the difference with Pope Sylvester is that...
Thank you.